So, hey guys, I got like a cold or something, so my voice is a little under the weather, but I'm getting better, so that's all that matters. So I forgot to make a video of me unboxing this chainsaw and running it and starting it the first like I did on 7310 video, which has almost like 7K views now. Which I really want to thank all the people that watched it, all my subscribers, all the people that's been here for a long time, and really thank you to all the people, all the new subscribers. Thanks for coming and joining the channel. I really glad y'all are here. So pretty much what I got here is of farmertec or Hulse Pharma. G466 or a stihl ms460. I would love this saw already. It's really powerful. It's probably broken in now. I put a handful of tanks through it. It's really rich. It's like two on the high and a one and a half on the low, but I'll turn it down to a one on the low and one and a half or one and a quarter on the high eventually, but let her be nice and rich while she's breaking in, but yeah, we'll talk about the Hulse Pharma bar and chain here in a second, but I just want to focus on the saw for a second. I ran it a little bit without the West Coast Saw Dogs and the bark box on there. Man, that bark box and the dogs, man, those are the thing I love. If you have a steel chainsaw that will have a bark box on it, you have to buy a bark box for it because they are like necessary. It wakes that saw up like nothing else does. And you will have to tune it a little bit, make it a little richer, a little leaner, something like that. Most likely a little richer, but I think because you're giving it more airflow. Or not really more airflow, but you're getting the air out faster, so yeah. Anyway, I really like it. It sounds amazing, it runs amazing, and the dogs, those things are aggressive. I mean, that thing's about the West Coast Saw Dogs. Is that they line up with the kerf and the cut or the bar. So, you still get pretty much your whole bar, really. In a sense, whereas with this, the dogs that just had this random right here that is useless because these two are the only ones you're ever really using. These are just there for looks, but personally, I think this one looks better. Man, the dogs and the bark box just look amazing. And I had the full wrap model. It's came in handy. I use the full wrap a lot more than I would think I was going to, but it's still running strong. I've got the West Coast Saw sticker on there. Still got the stock air filter. Got a decomp plug in there. Got a 28-inch Hulse Pharma bar. We'll talk about that in a second. West Coast Saw bark box dogs. Stock clutch cover. Probably gonna get a West Coast Saw clutch cover for that eventually. But for right now, keeping it like that. Yeah. I really like the saw. It's very powerful. Make sure to go watch my shorts I've been putting out and the video I put out. If it in the video and on the shorts, it was not really, ripping through it, and that has to do with because it's so rich and because it had a chain with 50,000s off the rakers. And that this saw, I mean, it'll pull it, but it just 35 to 40 is about the much I would go on the next chain. But the 50,000s off the rakers was really meant for the 660 to pull, but I just saw the chain, so and it was a sharp chain, and I needed to run it, so I threw it on there. And I mean, it ran good, there's nothing wrong with it, but it definitely didn't run as good as it does. With a less off the rakers, which I've been getting a really good grind on the Oregon grinder, And I mean, I've been getting them sharp. I've kind of like took off a little bit off the your top plate, which I'll show you on a second, and then kind of got down. It kind of makes a square grind, sort of. All I know, it's really sharp and it cuts super fast. So, not like a Simon tin or anything, or an actual square file, but it gets it sharper or sharper. It gets it the shape, it gets it sharper than factory, at least on this Hulse Farmer chain and on the Stihl RS. The C83, I don't know. I haven't sharpened much C83 besides on my 590, and I have a C83. What else do I have a C83 on? Oh, I got a C83 on the 7310 with the 20 inch bar. Make sure to go watch the video of putting the West Coast Saw Dogs on the 7310. They're not as big, like right here. They don't sit off as much off the ground, but man, they still. I've used those a lot more. I've actually thrown a chain on the 7310 and it's hit the thing and it, the dog, and it doesn't faze it. But, you know, there's other brands. I'm not going to say any names, but you know, if you're in the saw community and you know about West Coast Saw, you probably know those other brands. One in particular that's not really caught. I mean, I'm not going to say, but I just don't. I think West Coast Saw is the original who made the bark box and the dogs, the 3-point dogs and stuff like that. So I feel like I like West Coast Saw, and for the price, I mean, in the other brand, it's only a couple dollar difference, and I think the West Coast Saw looks better, and you know, the original, so it don't matter. I'm gonna buy West Coast Saw. Y'all can buy whatever y'all want, but that's my opinion, and we all have our own, so it is what it is. But to move on to the bar now, get enough talking about the 460. More to come on that eventually. So the bar, heck, I would buy another one, but I wouldn't buy another one. Like, if I needed a cheap bar just to go on a saw, just because I needed a bar, they're a great cheap option. But if you're cutting like firewood or tree service like I am, they I'm trying to think of what to say about them, because I mean, they're good for the money, I would say, but overall, because I'm pretty sure they have a steel tip on them. So maybe if you replace the tip on them, because they bend right here. This bar is already bent right here because it got stuck up and it bent right here. So it's a little bent right on that tip right there. So I don't know if another tip would fix that, or if it's the bar. I don't know. I'll probably end up buying another tip because I have one more of these 28-inch bars. And then the rest from there on out, I'm probably going to just buy a steel. Not a lightweight probably, because I might buy lightweight, but for my 28s, I have my Sugihara, and it's a good bar. But Sugihara, I like Sugihara because they look good and they're light, but overall, and they're not flexible much at all, and they're really good bars, really really good bars for the price. I mean, for the price, I have a what's the other one called? A Samara. Yeah, I have a 24-inch Samara, and they're about the same weight. And so far, I've ran like 10, 15 tanks on that bar, and I've ran about 20 on the 7310. So they're about the same. I will say on the Samara, the oil outlet on your bar is a lot bigger than on the Sugihara, because I go in there with the Dremel and I bore those out to make them bigger, and that helps a little bit with that, with them not getting clogged as much. But to get back on the MS460, the bar is okay. Would I buy another one? Maybe, for the price, because they're super cheap and they're nice. I mean, they're a good bar, especially for just the bending at the tip, but it is what it is. They are flexible, though, for a solid bar. That's one thing I will say about them, though. But the chain, though, this is like a copy of a stihl 33RS chain. RS 33, whatever. I'm pretty sure that's what I've heard, and they look about the same as my other 33RS chain I have. And I really like the whole Farmer chain. I would probably buy a Lupa chain from them for sure. Whenever I'm looking in the market to get a Lupa chain, start making my own chain. But I would definitely buy a Lupa chain, because for the price, and I've put about 3 grinds, and it's still pretty good on life. I'd put 3 grinds. I'd probably put like two grinds. So, and I just, yeah, I mean, I get my chain sharp. So you can say what you want in videos that my chains are dull or whatever, but I mean, they're cutting good, so it don't matter. Yeah, I see all over the internet all the time people going through and talking about, you know, criticizing people, saying, you know, your chain's dull and stuff like that and other stuff. I'm just like, I mean, people are gonna sit there on their couches all day and criticize people, but you're the only person that can say or not that your chain's dull, unless it's a reputable person, you know. Unless you're, like, learning knowledge and they're not just, like, bad-mouthing you, then if they're trying to help you and, like, saying, hey, if you do this, you might be able to get your chain a little sharper or something like that, or anything in the chainsaw world, really, and they're just trying to help you. But if they're just sitting there criticizing you, like, oh, your chain's dull, you don't know how to sharpen a chain, you should do this and that, that's when I'm just like, I ain't gonna even listen to you, even if you do know what you're doing, if you're gonna be a jerk about it, I mean, you do you. But yeah, I'm gonna make a video here in a second on the organ grinder, but I'm looking to have this ported eventually, cause I had my 660 ported one day a long time ago, a couple months ago, and I liked it, and then it blew up for just reasons, not the porter's fault or anything like that, just because the cylinder. So I'll probably, now I have a Wolf Creek Saw Shop, I have a Highway cylinder on it and a Meteor piston, not the big bore, just regular, so I might have that one ported. The 660 looks pretty bad. It's got the uni filter from Rub Your Saws with the adapter, and then it's got a Cobra cord on it. It's got the stickers. I love stickers. It's got the bark box on it. It's got a 32-inch stihl Roll-O-Matic ES bar on it with the 33RS chain fresh out of the box. So, yeah, do a little walk around. I have noticed that farmertec has started to put serial numbers on their saws, so that's kind of cool. But I will say, though, about a West Coast saw bark box is that if you like your saws to be all nice and clean in that area right there, you might as well forget it, because they will just coat that, and it'll be coated black, and comes with little flippy caps. I'm thinking about dyeing this all black, or all the plastics, or just keeping it blue or something. I'll probably just keep it blue, and then put a adapter and put a uni filter on this too, because I'm not a big fan of the max flow, just for reasons I have personally. Nothing against max flow or anything like that, but I just feel like uni filters like that one are better than max flow. I mean, max flow has a place because you can put a rain cap on them, but for me, I'm not, because all this really is to keep the rain off, really. And to keep your filter on if it's not, you know, something else, but really it's just to keep the rain off your filter. But so with that filter, well, y'all see it. You can't you can figure out a way to put, like, cut a hole, but you won't ever really have it fully protected from the rain. I mean, you could probably rig something up if you needed to, but in that case, max flow is the best option. Or, you know, have a little, so I don't know. You know, like the 500 eyes, they, a lot of the loggers put green weenies on them, or, you know, green uni filters, whatever. But I really like this all so far. It's people be saying hating on farmertec and stuff. I feel like they're good. I feel like they're getting better and better. And those Neotech saws, I just think they look cheesy with the gray and the orange. I like this because you can easily, you know, change it and make it look like a stock saw with a little bit of dye and plastic and stuff like that. That's not sure the case. You can't change the case, but you can, you know, you can make it dye it all black and make it look good. But that other stuff, that orange, I don't know. And I've also heard that Neotech, the quality isn't that great, or compared to Hulse Pharma. And I think Hulse Pharma is the king of the clone world, and will be for a long time. Maybe Hulse Pharma will come out with an Echo clone one day, like a big, you know, like one of their bigger Echo clones, not one of their little, like that little Echo they have that's not really worth to me buying, because I already have an ms250 for limbing and stuff like that. I mostly use big saws for cutting firewood and trees, and I'm not a climber yet. I'm going to be climbing eventually once I get all the gear and everything like that, so a top handle eventually. But for right now, I'm just felling the tree and cleaning it up and either burning it or taking it or something. So big saws and like ms250 limbing saws and, you know, 261s and stuff like that, or 50-40, you know, those kind of saws are all I need, and I already had those. So I'll probably be I'll probably get another 70cc. I'll probably get a 372 eventually, have it ported by Aaron or something. Because I kind of want to have multiple saws ported by multiple people. But the first person I ever have port a saw will be Aaron. Because I've told him I've going to have a saw ported by him for forever. So, Aaron, if you're watching this, it'll be in the future. I like to make sure the saw is good before I send it off and have it ported. Because, you know, just, I don't want something to blow off on me. And I'm sure your work is top notch, so I feel comfortable sending it to you, having ported. And then, you know, I'll probably have one of my other saws ported by Dino Joe. And then if I ever get an OEM 660, I'll probably send it out to Ripsaw or something. And then one day I want to have a 500i ported by John's Custom Saws. But alrighty, I'm going to get off here, guys. I'm going to probably release this video Thursday sometime this afternoon. And then tomorrow or Saturday, I'm going to be releasing a video on the Oregon chain grinder and some other stuff. So guys, thanks for watching Southern Firewood. Make sure to like, subscribe, and comment. If you're going to be a hater, stay out of the comments. Or if you do comment, your comment will be deleted immediately or as soon as I see it. So just don't even waste your time. Alrighty guys, thank you for watching Southern Firewood. All my new subscribers, a huge thank you. We're at like 269 the last time I looked. And to all my old subscribers, or not old subscribers, but the OGs, the people that's been here forever, or for a long time at least. And y'all make everything possible, because if I didn't have a YouTube channel, I probably wouldn't be making some of the content I do and doing some of the stuff I do. So, alrighty guys, have a great day.